Good morning. I just wanted to share what we went over in our sermon this past Sunday morning service. We didn't have night service due to the winter weather conditions on the roads, and I'm thankful everyone that I know and love was safe during that time. The title of the sermon was Washed in the Blood. Let's go to Revelation, first chapter, verse 4, says John, to the seven churches in the province of Asia, grace and peace to you from the one who is, who was, and who is coming, from the seven spirits before his throne. Now, speaking of the seven spirits, let's take a flight over to Isaiah chapter 11, verse 2. This is where the seven spirits are defined. See how well scripture correlates with each other. Backtracking all the way to the prophet Isaiah. This was years and years and years before Revelation was written. Says the Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, a spirit of wisdom and understanding, a spirit of counsel and strength, a spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And that seventh one was, of course, the way it opened. Said the Spirit of the Lord, that's what it all is tied back to. But wow, God's word is just awesome. And the more you study, the more you realize how little that we do know. And we're always going to be learning more about it. But anyways, back to verse 4 of Revelation. You know, said John was writing to the seven churches in the province of Asia. That was just west of Turkey, around the Turkish peninsula. You know, the Great Commission in Matthew 28, verses 18 through 20, that Jesus issues to his disciples, well, the Great Commission is for the local New Testament church. God has empowered the church to carry out the Great Commission. The time that you're living in warrants you to read, hear, and keep what's been written to us. Now, keep in mind, this is very foundational, very basic. But when you're being a witness, you have to know this, or nothing else is going to be this much effective. Any, quote, way to heaven outside of the blood of Jesus is a lie, in all capital letters, L-I-E, lie. Anybody who says you can make it to heaven on your own terms or by any other terms aside from Jesus Christ, that is a hell-sent liar. So until you get that, nothing else is going to be effective. Verse 5 says, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead and the ruler of the kings of the earth, to him who loves us and has set us free from our sins by his blood. That's what I was just saying there. Well, you know, talking about the firstborn from the dead, Jesus is never to die again. He defeated death. Game over. So, I know that was very foundational there. But it's stuff we constantly need to remind ourselves how crucial it is in our outreach. God bless you and have a great weekend.